Respiration in Living Organisms, Part 3.
The objective of this video is 1. To understand respiration in animals. 2. To understand about respiration in water. Children, you saw in the previous video how humans breathe and how the nasal cavity, lungs, diaphragm, etc. help in breathing and respiration. Like humans, other animals also breathe to survive. The main objective of this video to understand the respiratory process of various animals. Let us go to a village in Madhya Pradesh where Deepak and Ramesh live.
Deepak, help me clean the house. I have to make preparations for Diwali too.
Mother, there are 15 more days for Diwali. I will be playing for a while. Then I'll help you.
Go after some time. We all have to work together.
Mother, okay. Tell me what to do.
Look here. How many cockroaches are there in this room? They are moving around here and there. Oh, look here. There are 2 to 3 in this flower box too.
Mother, it surprises me as to how they are alive in this dough. If anything goes in my nose, I will be very suffocated. I wonder how they are breathing and how they are alive.
These cockroaches are attracted towards food and moisture. Cockroaches are therefore found mostly in kitchens and bathrooms. Let's do the cleaning.
Mother, look here. I have cleaned up the place here.
Deepak, let's go to play.
Hey Ramesh, you have a fish rod? Come on, let's go fishing.
There are very few fish in the lake, but we will try.
Ramesh, it's been a long time. We could not catch even a single fish. Now I'm feeling hungry.
Hey, wait. I think I have caught a fish. Yes, got it.
It is gasping. Leave it back in the water, otherwise the fish will die.
After a long time, a fish was caught in this hook. And you are asking me to release it in water? Okay, I will let it go back to the water.
Today, when I was cleaning the house and helping my mother, some cockroaches came out. I noticed that they were also alive in a place with less air. And now see how these fish are suffering as soon as they come out of the water. Let's go home and find out why this happens. Mother, do you remember that the cockroaches were roaming around on the floor? Ramesh and me will read in this book how cockroaches breathe and we shall find out if animals like cockroaches, frogs, etc. have lungs like us.
Deepak, look here. It is also written about fish.
Children, can you tell why whales and dolphins often come up on the water surface? Sometimes, why do they leave a fountain of water while moving upwards?
Ramesh, look here. Here we will read how animals like cockroaches, fish, etc. breathe.
These are all such small creatures. I don't think cockroaches and fish have lungs.
I know that animals like elephant, lion, cow, goat, etc. have lungs. Look here, everything is written about cockroaches. Let's read what is written.
Look here, something has also been written about earthworms, frogs and fish.
Look, like all other insects, there are holes next to the cockroaches called spirals. Out of these spirals, oxygen enters and carbon dioxide comes out.
And the air from these holes goes through the tracheal tubes all over the body.
These humans don't know much about me. You know, I can live without breathing for up to 45 minutes. I can also survive radiation and extreme cold.
My body seems very wet and slimy because I breathe through the skin.
I live on land and in water. When I live on the ground, I breathe through the lungs. And when I live in water, I breathe through the skin. Wow! What wonderful creatures these are and how they all have adapted themselves to survive.
But fish can only live in water. If we take them out of the water, they die.
Yes, but these fish have gills. We humans cannot stay in water much longer because we cannot breathe in water. Cockroaches can live in water for a long time.
These gills act like the lungs for fish, isn't it? They help the fish to breathe.
Yes, look here. Gills of the fish help in using oxygen dissolved in water. And look at this picture. Gills are on each side of the head. The fish takes oxygen-rich water and its mouth and pumps it to its gills. When the water passes through the gills, the blood vessels inside it absorb oxygen.
The smallest insect or the biggest animal, all must respire to survive, whether they respire with lungs, skin or gills.
Yes, you are right. Go home now. It has got late. See you tomorrow.
Children, you have learnt about the respiration of other animals in this video and about the respiration in water. In the next video, you will learn about plant respiration. See you later.